Good morning, hockey fans. It's Danny here with a quick video on some takeaways from the Penguins' first three games of the season. They're heading into their Tuesday night matchup against the Dallas Stars with a 2-0-1 record, and a big reason behind that is because they've been especially staunch in the defensive zone. They're not giving up anything at the net front and have been pretty good at limiting shots from the slot area as well. Now, leading the way for the defensemen on the defensive side of the puck is no surprise John Marino and Marcus Pedersen. In their 41 minutes of 5v5 time together, the opposition has yet to score against them, and they have yet to surrender an entire expected goal in that time. Now, that shouldn't come as much of a surprise just yet, because as you can see, when Marino and Pedersen are on the ice together at 5v5, the opposition is not getting anywhere near the slot or front of the net. All of their shot attempts are coming from the perimeter, low danger attempts from the half wall and the left point. Before the season started, I tweeted out that I would be monitoring the defensive play of Kasperi Kapanen and Jason Zucker. We know that both of those players, no matter who is centering them, are going to score goals at a decent rate and probably at a higher clip than what is expected of them based off the chances that they are creating. But last year, they were quite a tire fire in the defensive zone, and if they are able to clean that up even so much as a little bit, it's going to go a long way toward the Penguins dominating with them on the ice at 5v5. Now, this is only a 34-minute sample, and it's certainly nothing to write home about, but their results in the defensive zone have been nothing short of outstanding. They, too, have yet to be scored against together at 5v5 and haven't even given up half of an expected goal in that time. They have spent about 12 of their 34 minutes with Marino and Pedersen, so that's obviously something to consider here when looking at their defensive results, but even just watching them, they do look a little bit more engaged and more smart and sound in the defensive zone. Now, going back to the offensive side of the puck, it hasn't been the Letang-Dumoulin pairing or the Marino-Pedersen pairing that's leading the way offensively. It's been the pairing of Mark Friedman and Chad Ruedel. Now, you can see right here that the Penguins are basically just firing at will from anywhere they can in the offensive zone with those two on the ice. They've already scored two goals in just 30 minutes together, and they've almost generated three full expected goals. The emergence of Mark Friedman really just illustrates how useless Mike Matheson is to this team, and you know, it really leaves you wondering what the Penguins would be able to do with that extra $4.9 million in cap space. I will definitely be keeping an eye on Friedman's play going forward here. I'm not sure when Matheson will be back, but this will definitely be something worth keeping an eye on. As for the Dumoulin-Letang pairing, they haven't been all that great in terms of generating offense at 5v5. We do know that Chris Letang does have 4 points in three games, but they are struggling a bit to get to that net front area and have really been limited to just shots from the high slot in the offensive zone. Last year, we did see that Chris Letang's underlying play driving metrics dropped off quite a bit. I do think that they can rebound, but obviously these first three games aren't an indication of that, and they'll need to do a little bit better moving forward. The last thing I wanted to touch on was Drew O'Connor. We all know how much faster he looks and how much better he looks on his skates, but I'm extremely impressed with his ability to just fire the puck off, especially playing in a fourth line role with Brian Boyle centering him most of the time. In just 18 minutes, O'Connor's already fired 7 unblocked shot attempts toward the goal and obviously picked up his first career NHL goal against the Blackhawks and Marc-Andre Fleury on Saturday night. It would be an absolutely huge development for the Penguins if O'Connor can even continue to produce this at half the rate as he is right now, and would go a long way toward making the Penguins' bottom six that much more productive.